Hello, everybody. Thank you for coming to my session. Today, let me introduce my programming language, Edison, by showing its features that are useful for describing calculation in Riemannian geometry. Edison is a programming language that I created. I have been developing it since 2011. I am implementing it in Haskell. The aim of development of Edison is to create a language that can directly represent all algorithms that can be discovered, and it's a very big goal. Currently, my biggest challenge is to improve Edison in order to directly represent calculations that appear in mathematical physics. This challenge is important for computer science too, because this research will help us to use more advanced mathematics. Mathematics used to solve the problems in computer science depends on mathematics that we can describe easily by programming languages. So extending the area of mathematics we can describe easily is very important. The current version of Edison has three special features. First, it has a strong pattern matching facility. We can describe pattern matching against the wider range of data than the popular languages. Second, it supports symbolic computation as a Mathematica. It is implemented utilizing Edison pattern matching. Third, it supports tensor index notation. Let me explain all these features today. These features are useful to represent Mathematica physics in programs. Here is a list of calculations of mathematics in Edison. I am listing up these programs on my website. This is the current list. These green parts are programs for calculations of Riemannian geometry. That's today's topic. Before showing Edison program, let me explain what is Riemannian geometry. Riemannian geometry is the theory for investigating a curved space. It is easy for us in the three-dimensional space to recognize a two-dimensional curved surface is curved. But how about our world? Is it curved for who can recognize the higher dimensional space? Riemannian geometry provides a way for investigating our world is curved or not by investigating our world inside itself. After the establishment of Riemannian geometry, Einstein built the theory by which we can explain the reason of gravity as a curve of four-dimensional time-space. That is the theory of general relativity. This theory is described using the notion discovered in Riemannian geometry. Here, let me show the intuition of the reason of gravity. We recognize our space-time is flat that way. However, according to Einstein's theory, our space-time is curved that way. The line we recognize straight is curved for who can recognize higher dimension. And things move straight in this space-time. If we draw the straight line in the previous slide, the line is curved that way. This curve corresponds to the drop of a thing. In our recognition, it looks like things are falling. Formulas in Riemannian geometry are represented with partial derivative operator and tensor index notation. And actually, we can represent both of them consciously in Edison. Let me explain about that today. This is a sample of Edison representing the formula of Riemannian geometry. In Edison, we can directly translate the mathematical formula into a program. Please note that we directly translate partial derivative operator and tensor index notation in this formula. And these three features of Edison enables this concise notation. Now let me introduce them. First, let me introduce pattern matching against the wider range of data types. Here is a sample program of Edison, Edison pattern matching. Edison allows nonlinear pattern matching with multiple results. Nonlinear patterns are patterns that allow multiple occurrences of the same variable in a pattern. Nonlinear patterns is one of the special features of Edison pattern matching. For example, this is a pattern of Edison. And here, variable P appears twice in this pattern. It's a nonlinear pattern. Now let me explain this meaning of this program. Primes in this program is contain infinite list of prime numbers. We match against it as a list of integer. And this is a pattern. This join underbar eliminates several head elements from this prime number. And this const p extract one prime number and bound it to p. And this const p plus 2 matches only if next prime number after this p is p equal with p plus 2. And it returns p and p plus 2 as a tuple. And this match expression returns all successful pattern matching result and return as a list. And it is bound to this variable thin prime. And here we extract the first six elements from this thin prime. Then we can get first six thin prime number like this. And the specialty of another specialty of Edison pattern matching is that we can represent pattern matching against not only this, but for example, merge set like this. We can highlight program that return poker hands. Poker hands. When we implement poker hands, we regard a collection of cards as a merge set of cards. Here we pattern match card as a collection of cards, as a merge set of cards. And here, patterns for each poker hand are described very concisely. Next, let me introduce the second feature, customizable symbolic computation using Edison pattern matching. First, let me show what is symbolic computation. In symbolic computation, we can use symbols such as x, y, and I this way. In the first expression, we describe x plus y powered by 2, and it returns x powered by 2 plus 2xy plus y powered by 2. And in the second expression, we describe x plus y powered by 3. In the third expression, we describe x plus y powered by 4. In the fourth expression, we describe 1 plus I powered by 4. And this I is a unit of imaginary number. And if we multiply it twice, it returns minus 1. In this expression, we calculate the square root of 4. Here, we multiply square root of 2 and square root of 3, and it returns square root of 6. We can do such kind of thing if we support symbolic computation. And if we combine Edison pattern matching and symbolic computation, we can define the symbolic partial derivative in a very concise program like this. Pattern matching against mathematical expression is utilized to define them, it. A mathematical expression is a merge set of terms, and the merge set term is a merge set of factors. So Edison can pattern match against merge set, so pattern matching of Edison is very useful against to pattern handle mathematical expressions. Now, let me introduce the third feature, tensor index notation in Edison. First, let me show what is tensor index notation. Tensor index notation is a popular notation in the field of mathematical physics. Here are formulas from Riemannian geometry. We can see many indices are used in the formulas. These are the simplest sample of index notation. We represent the inner product, outermost product, and tensor product using tensor index notation. As in index notation, the position of index is important. As a first sample, when the index is repeated in the superscript and subscript, it calculates inner product like this. Same index is repeated in the same position, it multiply each element like this, and that is, it calculates outermost product. If the symbol used as index is different, it calculates tensor product like this. We can append multiple images to the high order tensors. In this sample, we represent multiplication of matrix using index notation. Index notation is necessary to represent the multiplication of higher order tensor, the matrices, because there are many ways to transpose them. This is a sample program of Edison using tensor index notation. The program below represents the above mathematical formula. In Edison, we represent superscript with a tilde sign and subscript is underscore sign. And these are programs that represent the same formula in Mathematica and Edison. And this is Mathematica program that represents this formula. And this is Edison program that represents this formula. Please note that double loop consisting of a table expression and sum expression appears in program in Mathematica, but Edison program is flat as a Mathematica formula. Edison expresses Mathematica expression more directly than the Mathematica, so there is a little difference in the number of lines. Actually, I published a paper that explains a method for importing tensor index notation into programming. Please read that if you have interest. Let me show you how we can describe the calculation of Riemannian curvature tensor as a sample application of Edison. Actually, we can write a program to calculate the Riemann curvature tensor of the surface of the sphere in one slide. In this part, we set the parameters and calculate the local basis. In this code, we calculate Riemannian matrix for the surface of sphere. In Edison, we can specify the type of indices in the variable name when binding a tensor to a variable. Yeah. Here we calculate Christoffel symbol of the first kind. Tensor index notation is effectively used to represent this formula. This term corresponds to this here. This term corresponds to this program, and this term corresponds to this part. Here we calculate Christoffel symbol of the second kind. The formula is directly represented. And this matches with this, and this matches with this. This is a part of program that representing the formula of Riemann curvature. I showed that several times in previous slide. We can see the result of calculation like this. We can also describe the calculation of rich and scalar curvature concisely. Next, here is a program that describes the calculation of the general theory of relativity. This program calculates the Riemannian curvature of Schwarzschild space, the spacetime where there is only one star in the origin, like this. If we analyze the result of this program, we can see the reason of gravity geometrically. Actually, I found the method importing tensor index notation into programming when I was trying to implement this calculation as concisely as possible, extending Ericsson. Finally, let me talk about my future plans. Currently, I am working to represent mathematical notation that are important in gauge theory, such as differential forms, exterior derivative, and Hodge operator. If we use these notation, we can represent homeless in mathematical physics more concisely as this. This is the Riemannian curvature formula that appeared several times in previous slides. This formula is represented like this. If we use notation, notion, uniform notion of closed theory. Closed theory is a theory in physics that appeared after Einstein's theory of general relativity. If we achieve importing this notion into programming, there are a wider range of applications in research of mathematics, physics, and computer simulations. That is the topic. Thank you very much for your attention.
Thanks for the presentation. It's very interesting because you can write, it seems that you can write complex mathematical equations on sizing. So my question is, your language can do like symbolical mathematical calculation, right?
Yes.
So it can find the derivative of functions?
Yes.
So the examples were like very complex. So can you show me, for example, like if I want to find the derivative of sine x, how do I write it using your language?
Okay. Thank you for your question. Now I show demonstration.
Okay.
You said
sine
x,
yeah.
Divided by x.
Yeah.
So,
Great.
Do you want me to hold it? Do you have some
My second question is, can you render the equation as an image, for example?
Currently not.
Okay. It would be great if you can do it.
You mentioned relativity, but relativity works in pseudo-Riemannian space with the metric G mu nu is hyperbolic, not elliptic. So my question is, you say Riemannian geometry, but then in the relativity, yes, it's pseudo-Riemannian with where the G mu nu is hyperbolic metric. And second question related, can you express global properties, because you write everything in local coordinates, but can you have global properties of the space?
Yes. I think just like this. As a future plan, I show the some curvature form is will be represented like that. If we integrate that, we can get a global characteristic. Mm-hmm. Is it correct?
No, but yes, but everything in coordinates. You have not only local coordinates, but you have also global properties of the manifold, which are what you write is true in a chart. But for a manifold, you need several charts. Mm-hmm. Until you merge them together to get a sphere, for instance, or the sitter space, or whatever.
Mm-hmm. Sorry, I'm not sure. Sorry.
Okay. And how does it compare with Mathematica? Is it more efficient?
It's slower. Sorry.
It's slower.
It's slower.
Any other questions from the room? No. Okay, thanks again.
Thank you.